The Boston Consulting Group is who we hired to work on this restructure that's directly related to why we're moving this this building over there. And that immediately triggered a memory that I had that somebody had sent me information on them. And so I just pulled some of it up, and we would have spent last year the money hiring this group to restructure, to do this whole restructuring and figure out how to move this department over and spend all this money on this new building. That group is partnered with the World Economic Forum, the World Bank, and the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, with the specific purpose of improving health equity and speeding worldwide progress toward the UN's health-related sustainable developmental goals. That's who we hired, and one of the main things they're working on is climate-related issues that they view as a key problem for public health in the future.
I'm aware of that, Mr. Morgan, and it's unfortunate. After, I think a lot of our constituents would agree, that is the last people we want in charge of making decisions for South Carolina.
Yeah, I mean, the fact that those people, not only did we pay them who knows how many millions to come up with the structuring bill that we just passed, but now we're going to be making these massive financial contributions to these new buildings that, when we have buildings that are perfectly fine to house these right now, it's crazy to me. Did you know that not only that we hired that group here in South Carolina? I mean, we all lived through the pandemic and saw the excesses of the federal government and Dr. Fauci and the WHO and the CDC, but now we hired that group to help us restructure. And now we're dumping who knows how many millions of dollars. And did you know also earlier somebody was talking about, you know, if we cut this funding, you know, it's punitive, that somehow we're punishing the agencies because we're taking the money away from them. And that was just galling to me, because who did we punish when we took this money in the first place? Is it punishing when we're taxing? Are we taking away somebody's money when we subsidize arts, or when we move and build nice new building plans when we already have buildings right now, when we're paying liberal consulting groups connected to the World Economic Forum to help us figure out how to do public health in South Carolina? You think we're punishing the taxpayer when we're taking that hard-earned money away from our kids and away from our families and wasting it on this kind of junk? Don't you think that's a little punitive to the taxpayer?
I think so, Mr. Morgan. Not getting beyond the scope of what we're actually discussing here, but I do not think the facilities in which we house our employees for the Department of Mental Health is really a factor of how we can help them. I think anybody that's in mental health crisis, I don't think they really care about the location of where they're going for these meetings or what they're doing. They just want to get the help that they need. So. I don't really know if that's really relevant now, but I get where you're going, and I agree that it's frivolous. But I also think that we should take that money and we should have put it toward a consulting firm to talk about how we can repair what we already have, and that would have been better served if we're going to use a consulting firm.
Ms. Cromer. Ms. Cromer is recognized for a question.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. So this whole search, it was never in the search to look for property to purchase?
From my knowledge, it was straight. We just went to a lease. We didn't ever have that option. If they did, I did not get that from the sub-hearing.
Why would it be better to lease something than to own it as a property?
Well, if I was the leasing company or the company that had it up for lease, I would say it was a win for me, but not for the taxpayer.
If you're looking at investing the taxpayer dollars, do you think it would be best to look for buildings that we can purchase and have control over, or the leasing option? I'm just trying to understand why we would only search for buildings that we can lease and not purchase if we needed a larger space.
Well, it makes sense to me when you're in charge, when you don't have the strings attached, when you own the building, when you can dictate the terms, like fixing it up. And then maybe possibly if you're ready for a new space, just like most homeowners, they sell the first thing they have first before they go into another mortgage or another payment and use the money that they have and the equity that they already have. Why would we not do that and be good stewards of the taxpayers' dollars instead of putting us on the hook for a lease with the unknowns. We have all the upkeep. I've been a business owner for a long time. I've had CAMs, I've had leases, I've had good landlords and bad landlords. Why would we put ourselves, because the last thing I said was, why would the government be, they're not in the real estate business. Why are we going to start that now? It only sounds to me like somebody's making a few dollars off of this.
Yeah, I mean, the government definitely shouldn't be in business, that's for sure. So do you think we should model our state? Should we look to California and model our state after California?
Absolutely not. That's why they're coming here in droves.
So it's concerning that you would hire a firm that is a globalist firm that wants to, one of their key things is you will own nothing and you will like it, pretty much.
Pretty much.
So this firm who works for World Economic Forum, they're telling us to lease property, although we already own property, but we're gonna lease property and we don't even know the plan for these other buildings. That just doesn't sound fiscally responsible to me. I'd be interested to hear your take on that. Thank you.
It doesn't either to me, Mrs. Kramer. Again, it's just beating a dead horse here. You know, I made my point about, you know, it's better to own and dictate the terms versus getting in a lease and getting involved with that. So, I mean, we've turned over a whole new precedent right here. Why not move every agency and you know, start leasing everything? But then tell me what the plan's going to be to sell those properties that we currently have. It could go to another investor or whatever, but then we're off the hook for it. Because guess what? That building, even though it may sit empty and there's nobody else in that building, you still have to keep that building up too. There's still going to be maintenance and deterioration, and you're still going to have to handle that eyesore, or your community's going to come after you to do something or tear it down. Again, at the cost of the taxpayer.
Thank you. Ms. Wetmore is recognized for a question.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Ms. Loremus, I appreciate, you know, I think you and I both share a desire to make sure that we are looking at every dollar spent and looking at how it can be best spent. And I know you mentioned your real estate experience. So in that experience, you're familiar, I would assume, with the costs of owning a building, maintaining it. I'm not personally familiar with the Columbia real estate market. Have you had experience in the Columbia real estate market?
No, but I've had much experience in South Carolina, Georgia, and Illinois.
Okay. And so certainly we understand that investing in real estate can sometimes be a good investment and sometimes not a good investment, right?
Correct.
And do you know that it surprises me, after the discussion we've had about the core functions of government, it surprises me to hear you and other sponsors of this amendment describe real estate investment as a core function of government?
I hate to interrupt you, but the first 10 minutes, Mr. Remus, has expired. Do you wish to take second 10 minutes?
No.
No, okay.
Yes, sure. If there's questions and she wants to finish, go ahead. Yeah, sure. Go ahead. Sorry, I didn't.
All right, Ms. Wetmore, are you finished? Or? Okay.
Sorry.
All right. Mr. Caskey is recognized for a question. Mr. Caskey.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and Mr. Remus. I appreciate your attempts to explain this. Perhaps you could tell us, what is the cost of the state's investment in purchasing the properties on Bull Street that we're talking about?
I apologize, what?
How much did the state pay for the buildings on Bull Street that you're talking about?
I don't remember the year that it was bought and how much they bought back in the day. We've owned it for some time. I apologize, I don't have that number. I'm not gonna make one up.
All right, well, let me ask you just then as a general matter, what happens when the state sells property? Where does that money go?
It would go back into the fund, I'm assuming, to purchase or acquire new land for different projects for government. I don't know where the money actually goes to. I apologize, I'm not on Ways and Means and I don't follow the chain of money and I'm not Curtis Loftus.
Given your extensive experience in real estate, is it your professional opinion that real estate today is worth more than what it was decades ago?
I don't know if it's worth more. It's just the inflation and the dollar value has gone up. A house that was maybe purchased in the 50s for $30,000, maybe a $250,000 home then. But also we know that things were very different back then in the 50s and 60s.
So do you think it's a reasonably safe conclusion to say that if the state were to sell the buildings on Bull Street, that it would net more money than if it had sold those buildings some time ago?
Possibly, but let's go ahead and sell it before we decide to move. Before we move into a new property, we could take the profit and the proceeds from that to purchase the next building instead of leasing it.
So you would agree with me, though, that the state will net money by selling these properties on Bull Street, right?
It depends on who the broker is that has it up for sale and what the commissions are. I don't know. Until that deal is made and somebody puts it up for sale and puts a value on it, there's a lot that goes into that.
So when you reviewed the Boston Consulting Group's report on the consolidation of our public health administration agencies, What page was the recommendation that the state start owning the properties as an essential part of this consolidation?
Mr. Caskey, I don't know about you, but I don't have a photographic memory to memorize what page what is on. When I read the information and saw where the group and the consulting group came from, I realized that does not align with the South Carolinian mindset. And so it is a part of what the country just suffered through during the COVID times. And I apologize, I just don't agree with what they have to say and what they're about. And we could sit there and change subjects and then it wouldn't be germane to this topic. But they are involved in things that South Carolinians should not be.
So, have you ever heard of Boeing? Do you know what Boeing is?
Just Boeing?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. In your opinion, is that a South Carolina company? Is that a
It is not.
Okay. Odd.
Meaning they do make planes here in South Carolina, yes.
All right. Have you heard of Raytheon?
I'm sorry, what?
Raytheon.
No. I can't understand what you're saying.
Do you know anything about any defense contractors who've used the Boston Consulting Group to improve the nation's ability to exercise lethality in combat missions around the world? Do you know anything about any of this?
I'm sure there's different groups out there, different consulting groups that you can contract with that align with your ideals. Yes, and I'm sure there's more than one option.
So just because a consulting group has a wide range of clients that you've dismissed all of their other abilities to contribute meaningfully to consolidation and creating efficiencies in any sort of large organization because you read a thing about a German guy who said a thing at a World Health meeting, and so now you don't have to take at face value any of their information or feedback, any of their analysis?
Mr. Cassie, I appreciate you trying to detract from the subject at hand and get me off track and off topic. I appreciate that. It's fun. I love it. But with what we're talking about here, we're not talking about so much the consulting firm here. I'm all about that we need to house this and consolidate and move things the right way. This is about being a good steward of the taxpayer dollar, and this is a bad investment. This is not about what we're doing with the restructuring. It's about the facilities. This is what this is about. It's taking it and putting it toward what it should be put for, either repairs of the current thing or sell what we currently have before we enter in. But leasing should be the last option for the taxpayer because of all the interest you're going to be paid. It's going to be paid. Somebody else is getting rich off of that. Is that fair to the taxpayer, Mr. Caskey?
So what I'm trying to get at, Mr. Remus, is the fundamental lack of information that you're bringing to this conversation. Because when I ask for details about the cost of the existing buildings, you don't have anything to offer. When I talk about or ask you about what the state would stand to gain from the sale of those buildings, you don't have anything to offer. We distracted for a while about talking about the consulting group, but when we talked about the fact that this same consulting group has a global presence all over the world in large organizations working from interests as diverse as the World Economic Forum to defense contractors to even, heck, the Saudi government. These aren't exactly left-leaning companies as you and others try to position them as. So nonetheless, we're here trying to talk about this because you're not offering much other than a generalized conclusion based on no numbers that I've heard from you, other than somebody added up 500 billion, is it, over 30 years? But you're not here to talk about the net present value, are you? You haven't done that math, have you?
I have not.
Okay. So we're just saying things up here because we want to be on the internet, it seems. So thank you for taking my questions.